The opinions made in this video do not necessarily coincide with that of Imaginary Goddess, or anyone else for that matter. Viewer discretion is advised.
King here with another State of Play for Set 9's release. I've just done a training with the King of some immense length, and now I'm doing this. I am certainly a glutton for punishment. There's a lot of crazy cards in this set. A lot of really good support. Like, this set's... Sorry, I'm just double checking something to make sure I've got all of a certain card. Mm-hmm. All right, this set's commons and rares are some of the best that we've had in a long while. Most of the commons and rares are good for what they're in, and very few are generic. Now, not all of them are necessary, because some, like this guy is blue wave only, but and honestly, this guy is a terrible example because he's not that good. It's one of those things that's like, I see why he's good, but at the same time, nah. Anyway, with some very interesting results that, quite frankly, I think will be pretty great. I'm going to do the commons and rares of each clan, starting with Aqua Force, and then just moving through it and however I wish to do. And we'll see where we go. Starting with the commons. Harpoon Draco Kid is a new starter. It's got Forerunner. Auto Rearguard, GB1. Fourth time only wave. When this unit attacks a Vanguard, for each other units with wave, this unit gets +4k until end of battle, and put this unit into the soul at the end of that battle. Basically, because he says other, so he doesn't count himself, there are Vanguards that have wave in them. So in other words, you could have up to 20k added to this guy for a 25k attack. With a booster, I'm sure, could hit something like 34k or so if it's a 9k booster or some other thing like that. For a really powerful punch in the fourth attack, that could win you the game. However, he goes into the soul at end of battle. So there's cards that give you actual hand advantage and field advantage that you kind of want a bit more than him. However, if you're ever questioning what you should run, this guy is an excellent decision, simply because he doesn't have anything that will not work. You know, you will hit fourth wave very easily. You just have to be careful to use him, you know? You could also use him with Storm Dominator Thavis from the back row, or just Storm Dominator Thavis, make him attack from the back row, +5k. That would mean he gets +16, so that's 26k to Vanguard. That's actually really good. And you can do things like Andre, give him like 28k to Vanguard, and restand his swing again, except then he wouldn't be as powerful and he goes into the soul, so it's like, he wasted it. Noob. Blue Wave Recruit Yoitis. This is a Blue Wave only card. Auto Rearguard GB1, Counterblast, put this unit in the soul. Technically you can use Forerunner with anything, but why? Don't do it. It's bad. Stop being an idiot. When your Vanguard with Blue Wave attacks, pay the cost. If you do choose a Rearguard, stand at +2k. That's alright. I think the starter that gives you hand advantage and a crit is better. Dolphin Soldier of Leaping Windy Seas. He's a stand trigger. He's actually a really good stand trigger. Auto Rearguard, GB1. First time or second time wave. Soul Blast 1 once unit attacks. If you have a Vanguard with Thavis, does not have to be the grade 3, can be the grade 4. You may pay the cost. If you do, +7k, and at the end of battle, draw a card and put this unit in the bottom of the deck. You do not shuffle. So you basically Soul Blast, send them to the bottom, and draw a card. Or draw a card, send them to the bottom. Whatever. And this is kind of to keep him from being like an infinite loop, like they did with that one certain Doctoroid. That we shall not name because its memory is too great. But honestly, he's pretty good. I've seen him work a couple times, and he's always worth it. However, remember, once you use him, you lose him. A reprint, Battle Siren Malika. I think this is her third iteration. Nice art. However, I like the original art best. Flambe Sailor. Sanji, is that you? It's a heel trigger. Battle Siren Cressida. Cressida. Auto, rearguard, wave fourth time or more. At the beginning of guard step of battle that your vanguard was attacked, pay the cost. In other words, during the fourth attack of your opponent. If you do, soul blast one, if you do, move this unit to guardian circle and it gets plus 5k until end of battle. Honestly, I see why she's useful. However, the offense of Aqua Force is much greater than its defense, and so you can't really use her as well as you'd like to. Blue Wave Dragon, Submerged Dragon. This is a guy I said earlier. He's basically a Battle Siren Cassia, or whatever her name is. If you have two or more cards with Blue Wave in the original card name on the Vanguard Circle, that includes Legion. Are you sure he doesn't mean Blue Storm? I don't think they have Blue Wave Legion. Anyway, this does count the heart card, though. So in other words, it's the heart card and the Strider for the ability, stride unit. This unit can attack from the back row. However, he doesn't get plus 2k for a 9k, so he can't even attack a rear guard. If he could attack the back row, from the back row, it would be better. However, I don't really feel this card does anything for this deck too much. However, he can get a back row attack, which can be useful, I guess. But then you have that one generic non-blue wave, one that works just as well. So, Blue Wave Soldier Simon. Come on. Simon? I don't know. Auto, Counterblast 1, Soul Blast 1. This unit is placed on Rearguard if you have two or more Blue Wave in the original card name on the Vanguard Circle, hard card included. You may pay the cost. If you do, choose one of your other units, that unit and this unit gets plus 4k. I mean, I can see how this can boost it because it's like 14k. Once you restand it with the guy who gives out plus 6k, to a column, you can give basically a plus 14k column. So if it's like 16, that's a 30k column right there. Probably with other abilities, but honestly, I wouldn't use him in Blue Wave. But then again, he's usable. I'll put it like that. Kelpie Rider Paul. Auto Rearguard GB1. Wave third time or more. Soul Blast 1. This unit attacks or boosts. You may pay the cost if you do. Choose up to two of your units plus 2k. So you can use them with like something like Lambros, but I see a lot of Thavis uses Soul Blasting, so you can go like do it twice or so, because there is no once per turn. You just have to have the soul for it. And again, I think soul is going to be a resource for Thavis people they have to be careful about. So even though he is pretty decent and he gives out plus 2Ks, which can make things like High Tide Sniper really good, I don't think we'll see much use. Blue Wave Marine General Lucianos. Act Rearguard once per turn. Counterblast a Blue Wave. If you have a grade 3 or greater Vanguard with Blue Wave in its card name, and until end of turn, this unit gets plus 2k and auto. Wave second time only. At the end of the battle that this unit attacked a Vanguard, stand this unit. So basically, you attack with something else, and during the main phase, you would have counterblasted a Blue Wave. Then you go swing, and then stand, swing for third, and then fourth attack, and then so on and so forth. You do have to be careful, though, because I believe this interferes with your stride that restands. Blue Wave Marine General Damia. Auto Rearguard Soul Blast 1. Not a problem for those guys. When your grade 3 or greater Vanguard Blue Wave attacks, pay the cost. If you do, choose your Vanguard and your other Rearguard, and those units get plus 2k until end of turn. You can give this to certain Rearguards that don't gain power but can restand, like Tidal Assault, as well as two other things. Honestly though, the plus 2k to the Vanguard won't affect anything. Stragglefin Dragon. This is actually a clone specific to Aqua Force that's been showing up in every clan. Like, they get one specific with their keyword. Auto, Vanguard, Rearguard, GB1. When this unit attacks a Vanguard, it gets plus 4k. Auto, Rearguard, wave fourth time only. Counterblast one, when this unit attacks, it's a Vanguard, pay the cost if you do stand. So in other words, you get a fourth and a fifth attack at 14k or more, which is pretty good, to a point. Just to a point. He is playable if you don't have anything else. Skyros is probably one of the best combos with Thavis. Blue Wave is Blue Wave. Blue Storm is Maelstrom. And generic ones, there aren't really any generic ones outside of Thavis. Speaking of Thavis, Kelpie Rider Valas. Canablast 1, Soulblast 1. When he is placed in the Guardian Circle from hand, pay the cost. Top 5. If two or more waves are called, this unit gets plus 5k until end of battle. If three or more units with wave ability are called, countercharge 1. Again, with the Soul Blasting, this guy is really only playable in a Thavas wave focus deck because if you don't get the countercharge off, he's kind of bad. His auto, though, is pretty interesting. Auto Rearguard TB1. Wave first time only. When this unit attacks or boosts, this unit gets plus 2k. However, he's just not playable for that ability. However, it's nice of them to think of us. There are other cards that return to hand and other things like that specific to Thavas. And I say Thavas because Thavas uses wave where others don't. Let me just check something real quick. Some of the others, like this guy, even though he has a wave in it, it doesn't count as a wave because the ability is activated by this and it's not right here. Like, the wave has to be right here to work. No wave. Yeah. No way to do it. Pity that's rearguard only. If it was from anywhere, you could just soul blast, it'd be great. So yeah, this guy only really works with Thavas, because Thavas is the only one that works wave. However, I'm sure that people can figure out something else and surprise me. Kelpie Rider Nikitas. Auto, rearguard, wave first time, second time. When this unit attacks a grade 3 or greater vanguard, this unit gets plus 2k. So he's an 11k attacker in the first or second turn. And then auto, rearguard, GB1, counterblast 1. At the end of battle, this unit attacked a vanguard, pay the cost. Choose another rearguard with wave and exchange positions. The state of the card doesn't change. This has actually been a pretty common ability throughout Aqua Force for a very long time. And basically what you can do is you can switch it with the thing behind it and attack again. and so you can get multiple attacks off. Maelstrom has one. There's a generic one or two. Basil did, but he's only a 10k attacker. So just the fact that she can hit 11k. He can hit 11k and switch places makes him a pretty decent card. However, there are cards that do that for free. So you do have to be careful with what deck and archetype you're using before you use him. However, if you're in Blue Wave and then you're playing this guy, who I'll get to in a little bit, that's not a problem. Then we have Blue Wave Marine General Jason. His ability is when your G unit with Blue Wave strides during your turn, and he's on Vanguard only, by the way, choose one card from your hand with Blue Wave, call it to Rearguard. Choose a Rearguard with Blue Wave until end of turn it gets auto, Rearguard. At the end of the battle, this unit attacked to Vanguard. Choose this unit, one of the other units in the same column, exchange the positions. So it basically does this with this, but with Blue Wave stuff. Let me think real quick. Sorry, I'm just thinking about what would be a good thing for it. Maybe this. Maybe these are supposed to combo up with the plus 4Ks and all that jazz, and you can get basically two attacks with this one. And say, I don't know, this one, let's just say. But, I don't know. Personally, I'm not impressed by him. However, for Blue Wave, I don't play Blue Wave, but for Blue Wave players, I'm sure he'll work great. Especially since they finally have multiple Blue Wave Grade 3s that they can use that are not Tetra Drive and are not Tetra Dragon. Then we have probably one of the best rares in this set, Marine General of the Twin Billets, Cretus. Auto, Rearguard, GB2, Wave, third time only, active during specified battles. Counterblast 1 when your Vanguard attacks, pay the cost. In other words, your Vanguard has to be the third attacker. If you do stand this unit, and if the unit attacked has the wave ability, that attack has the wave ability, so it gets plus 2k. So basically, if you swing with a wave Vanguard on the third attack, you can Counterblast 1, stand him, and if it has wave, he becomes a 13k, which can hit crossrides. Crossride meta isn't a thing right now. However, there are still some crossride cards like Dote and Brunhilder swimming around here with some badasses playing them. Always be careful. If someone pulls out a card that you're like, I haven't seen this card in years, and they're treating you seriously, and they seem to know what they're doing, be careful. They might have some tricks. Auto, Counterblast 1, Soul Blast 1. This unit is placed on Vanguard Circle. Pay the cost. If you do, look at the top 5 cards from the deck. Search for a wave. Put it into your hand. Shuffle deck. I don't know if I like this one better than Skyros. However, if you're going for a very offensive build over a defensive build for Aqua Force, and you can split it up between the two of them, because there are cards like Orinthia and Cressida, who are defensive cards in nature, you can do it. And she actually does count for wave. However, again, Soul, it seems to be a problem in Thavas decks, or at least will be. So be careful, don't run out of Soul. I'm gonna pause this and go into Gear Chronicle. Not too many Gear Chronicles this set. Hold on. Gear Chronicle. These guys didn't get too much this set. We have a couple rares and a couple commons. Nothing to write home about, however, they are getting their own third of a case with some interesting stuff in there that I think I'll pick up, but it's going to be cheap stuff, but it's going to be interesting stuff, how I like it. Heavy Wrench Draco Kid, new starter. This is, I believe, a clone that's showing up in some of them. Forerunner, act rearguard, tap this unit, choose another unit in the front row, plus 2k. Act rearguard, GB1. Put this unit into the soul, choose one of your units, plus 2k. So basically you can tap it and into soul for plus 4k to something. Or plus 2k to each card in the front row. I'm sure there'll be some uses for it in the future. Pulse Hypnosis Sheep. It's a stand trigger. It is a Zodiac Time Beast. Really, this is some Zodiac Time Beast support to really help the Zodiac Time Beasts along. When this unit is placed on rearguard from hand until end of turn, this unit gets put this unit into the soul, choose one of your other rearguards, and put it in the bottom of the deck. At the end of, and it doesn't have to be Zodiac Time Beast there. At the end of the battle, your unit attack to Vanguard, pay the cost. If you do, choose one of your Zodiac Time Beast rearguards and stand it. Honestly, this doesn't help Zodiac Time Beast too much because you need to put things in the bind zone. However, he has a good ability for an offensively based Zodiac Time Beast, of which there are a couple. Crit Trigger Zodiac Time Beast. Pulsar Tamer Nepata. If you have a Zodiac Time Beast Vanguard, this unit gets Intercept and Continuous. And this is a Continuous, by the way. This unit can intercept from the back row. It still retains its 5k defense, though. However, this unit also has an ability that's pretty interesting and could screw you over, could, might not. Continuous Rearguard Circle. If this unit is tapped, it cannot be chosen by the effects of the opponent's card. So it says resist, which is interesting and kind of fucks with Mega Colony. Good thing. Zodiac Time Beasts are kind of bad. Pulsar Speed Bunny. During your turn, this unit gets plus 1k for every other Zodiac Time Beast. Which is alright. Units. This does not count in the bind zone, which is a pity. If he was plus 1k for every card Zodiac Time Beast in the bind zone, he'd be pretty good. But he's not going to get more than like plus 4k, plus 5k, plus 6k if he's lucky. They're playing a Zodiac Time Beast Legion, of which there are none. These cards are kind of unplayable. She has some uses, and the fact that there are more Zodiac Time Beast triggers are better. However, neither of these really work with the Zodiac Time Beast winning image of getting off Demiurge. However, she can kind of. Just in a defensive way. These are two more Zodiac Time Beast cards. First one is Pulsar Stratos Falcon. GB1 Counterblast 1. This unit is placed on Rearguard Circle during each battle phase. You may pay the cost. If you do, this unit gets plus 4k until end of turn. Choose your other Zodiac Rearguards and exchange position. Say the card does not change. Bad. Why is it bad? Because multiple attacks with Zodiac Time Beasts aren't really a thing. The Counterblasts are actually fairly careful. You have to be careful about it. But I can see how if you run in some idea drones that you could really make get it to work. There are some decks that run only one of each Zodiac Time Beast, and I guess those do have some ability to be good. But honestly, I don't see how this... You know, it's just one more attacker that's an 11k, and if you face somebody who has, like, a cross ride, if you have somebody who doesn't care or has a trigger, it's kind of useless. No point. And even then, it's only placed on rearguard during each battle phase. So in other words, you're playing a fucking time leap version of this deck. That's not good. That's just bad. I don't like it. Anyway, Pulsar Flarescent Dragon. Counterblast 1, Soul Blast 1. Oh, we're seeing some more of these too. When your other unit is placed on Vanguard Circle and Rise of Zodiac Time Beast, you may pay the cost. If you do, your opponent chooses one of the rearguards and puts that when this unit is placed on Vanguard Circle. I mean, it's Vanguard Circle, excuse me. And Rise of a Zodiac Time Beast. So in other words, in a Zodiac only deck. Puts that unit in the bottom of his deck, his or her deck. Auto Rearguard, GB1, Counterblast 1, Zodiac Time Beast. When this unit attacks a Vanguard, you may pay the cost. If you do, choose one of your opponent's rearguards and it puts in the bottom of the deck. Whatever. It's mediocre and it doesn't bind anything. If it bound things, it would be good. But it doesn't bind things. So it's bad. Alright then. The next clan is Spike Brothers. See you soon. Alright, Spike Brothers. First off, they get a new draw, which is next to useless. However, it is a nothing. It's not Dudley, it's Dandy. Why would they make him Dandy? I guess he is Dandy, but he's got a gun. This isn't football anymore. We have a reprint. Oop. Excuse me. Reprint with Silence Joker. Put this unit into the soul from rear of circle as an act. If you have a Spike Brothers Vanguard, unflip a damage. He's a really good card. And he was actually a common that was worth something for the longest time. Then they reprinted him. Cheer Ghoul Sandra. It's a heal trigger. It's a succubus, but it's actually a really fantastic art. I love this art. It is dynamic. It is fantastic. It is a cheer. I love it. Dudley Little Road. He's a doodly guy. Auto Forerunner. Auto Rearguard. Soul Blast 1. When your Vanguard with Dudley attacks, you may pay the cost. If you do, bind this unit face up, call it to open R. If the number of rearguards with Dudley in his card name are 2 or more, this unit gets plus 3k. Basically, I'm just trying to think. Alright, so there are ways to boost him up, and there are ways to, like, sort of boost him literally. So you swing, Vanguard attacks. Place right here, plus 3k, it's an AK. You can put triggers on it. Because it goes literally bind zone, out. You put triggers on him, you can give him another booster. You know, he's just pretty good. If you have a booster here and a booster here, he's guaranteed to have it. And with certain Dudley cards, he can give out more power, which means that, yeah, he's pretty good. Interestingly enough, you don't have to use him with as an attacker. You can actually use him as a boost, bind him, Soul Blast 1, put it out here, boost again with an AK this time, which is pretty nice. Then we have, Mecha Coach. Put this unit into the soul at the end of battle that another of your charging rearguards attacked. Pay the cost. If you do, bind all rearguards, same column as the attacker. Call them face up, and then call them a separate open rearguard as tapped. If you're playing a stand deck, I guess, but honestly, this isn't as good as Mecha Trainer, who is the best. However, this does mean that you can make a give another rearguard charging, which can help Dudley Supernova. Air Force Eliza. She has charge. During the turn that the scene is placed on rearguard due to an effect, you may have it become charging. If you do, put it at the bottom of the deck at the end of its battle. Interesting. So in other words, this includes boosters. Yeah, this includes boosters. I don't think people knew that. I'm going to have to talk to someone about this. Chance, if you watch this, come back, King, if you watch this, look up the rulings for this for me. I'm going to talk to you about it before this is put out, but let's take a look at this. See what we can do with it. Auto Rearguard GB1. Counterblast 1. At the end of battle, if this unit boosted a charging unit, you may pay the cost. If you do, I think this includes... I'm going to have to look this up. I think it might include the boosting. You may pay the cost. If you do, bind the boosted unit face up, call it to open rearguard circle, and if that unit is charging, that unit gets plus 2k until end of turn. Put this unit in the bottom of the deck. Basically, there's a YouTuber called Living Proof. I haven't seen all his videos, but I should. Where he basically breaks down the Spike Brothers clan. He is to Spike Brothers what I am to Mega Colony. Except I don't put out nearly as much videos as he does on Mega Colony because nothing's happening. So basically, basically she gets multiple attacks from boosting a charging unit. And you can get it out multiple times. And then if it's charging, it gives plus 2k to the unit. That's whatever. However, it does work with Mayhem Tiger. Uh-huh. She also prevents charging units from going to the bottom of the deck and instead calls them back out. There are ways with using, I'm sure, the triple double rare that works with the Kenoblast 1, Soul Blast 1. Axe Diver? There we go. Who probably can prevent her from going into the bottom of the deck somehow. There are ways to really preserve it card advantage, but remember that would cause two counterblasts and a soul blast, and that probably wouldn't be a good thing. However, that would be interesting if you could. But I'm probably sure the wording of it prevents it from being chosen again, but I'll do some research on it. Full speed Spectre, charge. End of its battle again. Auto rearguard GB1. Counterblast 1. When this unit becomes charging, pay the cost. If you do until end of turn, it gets plus 4k. And this unit can attack from the back row. What's good about him is that he's just multiple attacks and he's an 11k guaranteed. Honestly, you could use him to soften up the opponent and then start and bring in the big guns like Mayhem Tiger or Heave Wheeze, or Lethal Forward, who is a really good card. Not much else to say about him. He's just good. There's a lot of counterblast usage in this deck, which is probably why they reprinted Silence Joker. But honestly, you do have to be careful because that is an advantage that Spike Brothers do not recover easily. Dudley Ingram. This guy's okay. Auto rearguard GB1. When your other unit with Dudley and is placed on rearguard circle during your battle phase, this unit gets plus 3k. Now, you can do a lot with Dudleys that way. However, and you can give like things like plus 5k for a counterblast when they summon out, but honestly he's like sort of thing. Like he's really meh. Because the plus 3k's you can give out plus 5k's and all kinds of stuff like that. You know, he's just overshadowed by other people who are more awesome. However, he does have a place in Dudley decks. Mayhem Tiger. This guy has a place in every deck. Charge. Auto, rearguard, GB1, soul blast. When your opponent puts a unit in the G during battle, let this unit attack the vanguard. If this unit is charging, pay the cost. If you do, choose one of your opponent's grade 2 or less guardians and retire it. Now, it does not cancel out perfect shields, but it can kill interceptors, grade 0s, and grade 1s, like a quintet wall or something like that. And by the way, let's say they quintet wall you. They can't stop the quintet wall. But every time you go, kill, 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 I'm out of soul. But otherwise, kill. And especially with certain decks, like, for example, a Legion Baden Dragger deck, that would cause it to hit an easy 24k, which causes them to be beyond. That's or more. And that's basic. Let's not kid ourselves. That unit is perfect shield or D-guarding or nothing. The only thing is charging. You have to be careful. Charging is a bit of a bitch, but I'm sure that most people can take care of it if they play Spike Brothers. This is one of those clones I was talking about earlier for Aquaforce. Charge, auto, vanguard, rearguard, GB1. When your other unit becomes charging, this unit gets plus 4k. Interestingly enough, every time a unit becomes charging, let's say that you're on a rearguard circle and you use Supernova and you happen to put 3 units into charging. That means that this gets plus 12. That's really good. He's an 11k as well, so that's like 23k. And then when this unit is placed on Vanguard Circle, choose one card from your hand, call it to open R, and that unit gets plus 2k. That actually is a free charge unit then, and immediately gives him a plus 4k. And again, depending on how you do it, it could get really beefy. However, the problem is that he's kind of... And there's a card called I've forgotten, but it's a grade 3. GB1. When this unit attacks a Vanguard while it's charging, it gets plus 10k. And that guy's just really good. Because he gets a bit more, but at the same time, if you get a really charging deck, he can be really good too. You know how it is. It's one of those things that's like, Outrage Lineback, charge, Vanguard Rearguard. When this unit attacks a Vanguard, plus 4k. Oh, this is the clone. This is a unit by itself. I'm sorry. This is a 10k. Auto Rearguard. Put this unit into the soul. When this unit attacks, it's a Vanguard. Pay the cost. If you do, put it into the soul. Call to open R. This is a better Skydiver. However, Skydiver is 11k. However, this unit works Vanguard Rearguard Circle. However, I do like the fact that he gets plus 4k when he attacks, so he's a 14k boosted. That could be 21k, and if you call cards like, where is she? Air Force Aliza, you can get multiple attacks out of him, and even hit for 16k once he gets plus 2k. That's the commons for the set. They are really good. You might be like, well, these two didn't waste space, but at the same time, there is place for them for the common player. Mayhem Tiger is probably one of the best cards in the set and one of the best twos we've seen in a long while. And there's a triple rare called Morfessa that's a grade two that's almost better than this in certain ways. But just the fact that you can just go, nope, until your opponent loses too much hand is just fantastic. If he was once per turn, he'd be bad, but he's not. He's unlimited. As long as you can pay the cost, pay the damn cost. Anyway, resist units don't work on me. You know, resist, you know. Anyway, read your units, because if they sucker punch you with something, yeah, it's your own fault. Dudley Jetter, auto rearguard GB1, retire this unit at the beginning of the ride phase. If you have a Vanguard with Dudley, you may use a Dudley guy. Pay the cost. If you do, until end of turn, if you stride a G unit with Dudley, you may stride without paying the cost the next time you stride. So basically, ride phase is before stride phase. So at the beginning of a ride phase, just pay him off. He's GB1, so you have to at least ridden once or G-guarded once. And then you stride for free, which can really help Dudleys. Dudleys have gotten a lot of support that I'll do when I cover the double rares and the triple rares that really put them up in the next level and give them a lot of strengths and a lot of attacks. Dudley Caligula is great. And honestly, Dudley Jessica and other cards, grade 3 Dudley and stuff like that, do a lot of work. And honestly, it's just Spike Brothers just got so much good support. Like there's no card in here that I consider bad. There's just cards like Dudley Ingram and Mecha Coach that I just consider mediocre. Though there's this guy, he's bad. He should be ashamed of himself. But other than that, other than this guy, there's no real bad cards. Like, not even the reprint's bad. This Heal Triggers art is amazing. Then we have a Quintet Wall of sorts. Dudley Cheers, Linda. She's cute. But Succubus, Soul Blast 2, Dudleys. When this unit is placed on Guardian Circle from hand, pay the cost. If you do, reveal 7 cards from the top of the deck. Call all cards with Dudley and their card names to G unit. And they get plus 5k guard until end of battle, put the rest in your soul. Basically, what you can do is, if you do it right, you can basically give all your non-triggers Dudley. And, hold on, are there any Dudley triggers? I don't think there are any Dudley triggers, or at least there aren't very many of them, that I know of. There's none in this set. Basically, your triggers are going to go into the soul, so choose cards that can be... just choose your cards wisely. If you run a full Dudley deck, which this card does require, it's not going to be hard. Because think about it, if you get, let's say you get 7 cards that are not, like, triggers, or that all have Dudley in their name, and they're not grade 3s, that means you get 70k guard for Soul Blast, too. That's pretty good. She funds her own abilities, but the problem is that she will deck you. So be careful. It's assumed that any cards you guard with are put into the drop zone. Lethal Forward, a great card. Charge. Auto Rearguard, GB1. When this unit becomes charging until end of turn, this unit gets plus 2k, and when this unit attack hits a Vanguard, if you have a Vanguard with Rising in its card name, so in other words, it's only to do with Nova, You can search for one card other than Lethal Forward from the deck, call it to open Rearguard Circle, and shuffle deck. Basically, he's another attack for free. When this unit becomes charging and gets plus 2k, there's ways to give him plus 5k. So 16k, plus let's say there's a Frog Leaper behind him, so he gets another boost for 23k, except you gave the Frog Leaper two triggers. So in other words, he's 36k, swing, hits a Vanguard. Let's see here. I'm just remembering what this does. If you have a Vanguard with Rising. Okay. So in other words, this goes back into the bottom of the deck. It hits? No? Sorry. I thought I understood what this card does, but it's too late for these sort of things. Basically, it hits. You have an open space over here. You summon over thing here. It goes in here. Sadly, you cannot call Lethal Forward. There we go. But you can call other things that might do other more terrible things, because this doesn't require charge. Huzzah. Also, it can summon out a booster for your Wink Killer Misery. It can do anything. It can do just about anything. It's a great card. I love it. I personally love it. However, it doesn't really seem to see much play because it's a Rising Nova only card. Dudley, Turbo Grappler. Turbo Rappler, actually. Turbo Rapper? Anyway, auto Vanguard once per turn. When a unit with Dudley in its card name is placed on rearguard during your turn's battle phase, this unit gets plus 5k. And then it has, and this is basically when you cannot stride. Then we have when your G unit strides, choose up to one of your Vanguards, and it gets auto Vanguard, Soul Blast 1. When your rearguard with Dudley attacks, pay the cost. About that, power went out. Basically, he allows you to keep attacks, put the units in the soul, basically self-funding in an infinite loop sort of deal. Soul Blast 1 plus 5k at the end of the battle going to soul. So he doesn't really work with charge very well, but he does keep the deck thin and prevent things from going back into the deck based on certain abilities. Anyway. That's sort of it for him. He's a really good card, honestly. And he works great with Dudley Jessica. However, I don't think he's quite the best. And I'll talk about the double rares and triple rares at a later date. But overall, really strong support from Spike Brothers. And honestly, I think we'll be seeing more toppings with these guys. Just because there's so much more you can do with them. Alright, let's move on to the next one. Narukami. Time. Now, the support for this is basically Voltage or Descendant. I don't think there's anything Brawler. Yeah, I don't see anything Brawler. But, there's still some good stuff here. And you might say, well, it's Eradicate. No, it's Descendant. Watch. Forerunner. Auto Rearguard. GB1. When your Vanguard with Descendant and its card name attack hits a Vanguard, you may return this unit to its hand. It's kind of a bad card, but honestly, having another plus 10k and another Eradicator to work with is just great. Honorable Monk Dragon. He's a draw trigger. Demonic Dragon Nymph Cordo. They always want heal triggers around so people can start up pretty easily because you need four heals. Don't play heals if you're stupid. But, you might be like, well, 7Cs can play without heals. That's a cheap deck. Less than $40 that can play all grade 1s if they wanted to. Or all grade 1s and grade 2s, rather. That's different. That is a different situation. That is a freak of nature. Djinn of Rainy Dust Storm. Auto, GB1. When this unit is placed on Rearguard Circle, this unit gets plus 3k. Until end of turn, choose one of your units, and until end of turn, choose one of your units, and that unit gets auto, VR, Thunderstrike 1. See that? Thunderstrike 1, very important. It prevents the weakness that previously existed of someone just laughing at you and playing nothing. And then guarding Chatura, Zoran, and Voltage. Thunderstrike 1. This unit attack hits a Vanguard. Your opponent chooses one of his or her rearguards, retires it, and binds it face up until end of turn. Basically, he doesn't really do anything special, but at the same time, a Thunderstrike 1 ability is really good. Especially if you can get it early game when you first stride. Eradicator, Strike Slasher Dragon. Auto Rearguard GB1. When this unit attack hits a Vanguard, during the battle, this unit boosts it. If you have a Vanguard with Descendant, counter charge 1. That's okay. I didn't think that the Senate had much counterblast problems, but whatever. Otto Rearguard, once per turn into battle with the Senate, attacked if the attack did not hit Soul Charge 1. Some of the units do use Soul Blasting, but other ones Soul Charge, so it's one of those things where it's like, meh. A lot of this Narukami stuff is meh. Grudge, Toxin, Eradicator, Swaybo. Otto Rearguard, Counterblast 1 with your Vanguard with the Senate in its card name. Attacks, pay the cost if you do choose one of your other units, that unit, this unit. Get plus 4k until end of turn. You know, it just gives out power. And if it attacks multiple times, you can give out multiple power, but then you're using so many Counterblasts, which is probably why they released this guy. But at the same time, you know, I'd run them just because there isn't anything better. Dragon Dancer, Fatine. Almost said Fat Line. Auto Thunderstrike 2. Soul Blast 1 when this unit is placed on Rearguard. Pay the cost if you do draw a card. Basically a better Phoenix, which was a guaranteed card in basically every Narukami deck. I would run her. Martial Arts Dragon. Auto Counterblast 1. Soul Blast 1. When this unit is placed on Vanguard, pay the cost. If you do, choose one of your opponent's Rearguards in the front row, bind it and bind... Retire it and bind that card face up. That's good. If you have to ride this as grade 2, it's good. Continuous Rearguard Circle. GB1. And it gets it early. It gets it so early. That's very important. Thunderstrike 2. When you're active, when your opponent's bind zone is 2 or more cards. During your turn, this unit gets plus 3k. So he's a 12k attacker for voltage. That's what it's saying. And then if you have to ride it, you can kill something and retire it and basically get Thunderstrike 1 real early. Oh, like for him. Zoom Dive Dragoon. Auto, Vanguard, Rearguard, Thunderstrike 2. Oh, wait, not a GB. I wonder what they're doing. Counterblast 1, choose up to 3 units with Thunderstrike in the front row and they get plus 2k. That's kind of bad, though. However, you can just keep doing it. Eradicator, Lightning Phoenix. I think this is the one that was sold last to draw a card. Anyway, auto. Like it, but then it got a grade 2. That sort of thing. No, it was Rising Phoenix. Sorry. Counterblast 1 when your Vanguard with Descendant attacks. Pay the cost if you do choose one of your other units. And that unit of this unit gets plus 4k. Basically, if you combo him up with Swaybo, you can get plus 16k to a column. That's pretty good. Or plus 8k to the front row. Rearguards, which is also pretty good. But honestly, a lot of counterblasts, and I don't really see the point of it. Too much, because it's like one of those things, either they can defend or they can't defend, it doesn't matter. Groundbreaking General Bishem, auto, Vanguard, Rearguard, Thunderstrike 2, Counterblast 1, Soul Blast 1, when this unit attack hits a Vanguard, pay the cost, if you do, reveal cards from the top of the deck equal to the number of bound cards, search for 2 cards with Thunderstrike from them, call them the separate Rearguards, shuffle your deck. At the end of turn, bind those units called with the effect face up. Huh, he does work with Dungaree. A little bit. he has multiple attacks. He's actually pretty good. He has multiple attacks. He works on Rearguard Circle. Thunderstrike 2, not GB. That's not bad. Huh. I might use him. But not in Dungaree. Dungaree's kind of dead until they give him specific support to make him good. Ascetic Draco Kid, Thunderstrike 1. When this unit boosts Forerunner, this unit gets plus 2k. So he's a 7k booster at all times when you have Thunderstrike 1, which is really easy to do. Auto Rearguard GB1, retire this unit. When any Rearguard other than the unit retired from Rearguard do the effect... Hold on. When any player's Rearguard other than this unit is retired... from Rearguard, doing the card effects during your turn, you may pay the cost. If you do, your opponent chooses one of his Rearguards, retires it, binds it face up. Basically, if you face a retire happy deck, he becomes a suicide bomb. You gotta be careful. If you're retiring people very happily, as you do with Narukami, he does it more. He's just a really good card. I am planning to run him. But not even the 7Ks. That's not important. Like, the fact that he can kill something else for just his retire effect. A starter is not a plus one or a minus one at any point in time. However, it can give you pluses or minuses. but his plus is really good. If you're stuck at Thunderstrike 1, he can be, make you a Thunderstrike 2 instantly. Trainee Monk Dragon. Thunderstrike 1. No G requirement. Auto rearguard. When this unit attacks a Vanguard, it gets plus 2k. Act rearguard GB1. Put this unit into the soul. Choose a Vanguard with Vanquisher until end of turn. It gets, when this unit attacks a Vanguard, choose one of your opponent's rearguards. And this unit battles both the Vanguard and the rearguard. And the other unit with the chosen, on the chosen rearguard circle and one attack. That's to prevent people from being like, I attacked the Legion Mate. But honestly, this is just a good card. It allows you to hit multiple with Vanquisher VMAX that I think will really make it a little bit more powerful than before. Besides the non-GB Thunderstrike 1 ability, which is pretty good in and of itself, since you've got cards like this guy, who is a 12k attacker. Eradicator, Dragonic Death Scythe. Death Scythe returns all the way from set 6. Auto, Counterblast 1, when this unit is placed on Rearguard Circle. It used to be a really expensive card. If you have a Vanguard with Descendant in the card name, pay the cost. If you do, your opponent chooses one of his or her Rearguards and retires it. So a Descendant support. All Eradicator stuff seems to be Descendant right now. Then Auto Rearguard, put this unit into the soul. When your unit with Descendant is in its original card name is placed on Vanguard Circle from Stride or otherwise, you may pay the cost. If you do, choose an opponent's Rearguard in the front row and retire it. Basically, you can kill two Rearguards with this unit. Which can empty out a front row. I mean, he's a rare. He does rare things. Roaring Thunderspear Jalil. Auto Vanguard G-Break 1, Thunderstrike 2. During your turn, this unit gets plus 4k and your opponents cannot intercept. That's a good ability, especially since this is a continuous. A lot of Narukami stuff have weird continuous abilities, and they can even cancel them out if they wanted to for some reason. So, you know, this is in keeping with the Narukami spirit. Counterblast 1, Soul Blast 1, place on Vanguard Circle. Top 5 for a Thunderstrike. Reveal it, put into hand, shuffle deck. He's pretty good. I don't think he's... I'm thinking I'm going to use Bishan over him. Just because Bishan interests me. And he's not Thunder G-Break. But this is still a good card if you want to run Thunderstrike. And run, you know, something pure, I guess. I don't know. Polestar Eradicator Zuiton. This is a companion for Descendant. Auto Rearguard. Counterblast 1. When your Vanguard with Descendant attacks, if you do, this unit gets plus 5k. It can get up to 2 plus 5ks, basically. Auto Rearguard. When your Vanguard with Descendant attacks, you may pay the cost. If you do, choose one of your Vanguards and it gets plus 5k. So if you think you can make push for game through the Vanguard, retire him. Attack with him first and retire him. If you think that you will require, the opponent has like 2 perfect shields in hand, give him the plus 5k. That's how he works. I mean, there's not much to him. I wish there was more to say about him, but that's that. I do like Bisham. I do like this starter. I do like this grade 1. The stand trigger's really good. The Descendant support's okay, but this is bad, I think. She's good. Fatine. He's good. Bad, kind of. Interesting. Bisham is interesting. He is not good. He is not bad. He is interesting. And you might be like, Ben, blah, 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 which is how you sound to me. All of you. No, I'm kidding. You know, why is he like this? It's because he can do things with, say, her or him. You know what I mean? Anyway, that's Narukami. I will do Angel Feathers next. Angel Feather time. Another clone. Black Omen. Full. Auto Forerunner. Auto Rearguard. Tap it. Plus 4k. 2k to something in the front row. Act Rearguard. G-Break 1. Put this unit in the soul. Plus 2k to any unit. So about this clone. It's a pretty decent clone. However, it does have the problem of being a negative. With no minus except no plus except to give something power, which may or may not kill something. So it's one of those cards that are kind of like, no. There are better starters, is what I'm trying to say. Teardrop Phoenix, it's a heal trigger. Doctroid Phileas, it's a draw trigger. High Trouble Angel. Stand trigger. It goes in the soul. Choose something. Give it. +3k. Pretty good, actually. For a stand trigger, you always want all your cards, as many cards as possible, to have abilities, including the triggers. So just having this in every deck as a stand trigger works out, especially if you don't have Noseal. First Aid Corgi. First time I saw this guy, I thought it was Fat-Ass Corgi. But this guy... when this is placed on rearguard, choose two of your other units with Rescue, +2k. If he had Rescue, he'd be good, even if he didn't do anything. If he just had Rescue when this is placed on rearguard from drop zone, damage zone. But, you know, he ain't bad, but he ain't good. Thousand Ray Pegasi. My Little Pony. It's got a lot of needles. let's not kid ourselves. This Pegasi has a lot of needles. But it looks like a My Little Pony. Auto Vanguard Rearguard. When a card is put into the damage zone, if you have an Angel Feather Vanguard, this unit gets +2k. Until end of turn. Basically, it's a reprint. It is a reprint with worse art, somehow. However, this art, Million Ray Pegasus, which does the same thing except at grade 2, is pretty good. Pretty good art. Black Relief Rotoron. Auto Rearguard GB1. Counterblast 1. When your card is put into the drop zone from your damage zone, do the effect of your Rescue, which is often, pay the cost. If you do, call the card that was put into the drop zone to another rear yard, same column as this unit. Basically, she allows you to preserve the advantage you take from the damage zone and put into the drop zone. And, you know, if you got a booster that you really need, like, say, Hair, or actually, would he work? Yeah, he would work. For the cost of Counterblast, which is not much of a cost at all, an Angel Feather anyway, you can get a +1 to the field. Which is not the same as a +1 to hand, it's just a +1 to field. I think a +1 to field is like a 7.5 to the hand. Because it's not from hand to field, so it's not a minus one to hand, +1 to field. But at the same time, anyway, it probably caused some minuses in the past somewhere. Artistic Celestial Mercurial. When this card is put into the damage zone, if you have a Vanguard with Celestial, put this card into the drop zone face up. From face up, excuse me. If you do, reveal 4 cards from the top of your deck. Choose a card other than Artistic Celestial Mercurial from among them, put them into the damage zone face up, and the rest into the bottom of the deck in any order. Honestly, she's good to get the copy into the damage zone, but other than that, she's kind of meh. I'd run her at 2 or 3 up. Maybe 1 up. 1 to 2. 1 to 3. Elastic Bipolar Ratiel. Auto Vanguard Rearguard once per turn. GB1. Counterblast 1. Soul Blast 1. When your card is put into the drop zone from the damage zone, do the effect of your Rescue. Pay the cost. If you do, call the card that was put into the drop zone to another rearguard, same column, and that unit gets +2k. It's better as a grade 2, but it's not as good as a grade 3. Simply because there are a lot of really good grade 3s and angels right now, and you can't really afford to give it to this guy. And he's a once per turn. She is not. Not that you would want to. However, you can actually refill an entire column while this unit is tapped. So basically, let's say you take out 2 using Gabriel Stride skill. You can then replace this and another thing. Replace the other thing first, then replace this. Just saying. That's the order you want to do it in. Anyway. That's the commons. Hibbit. Let's do rares. Absorb Celestial Baharia. Damage zone. Soul Blast a Celestial and put this card into the drop zone from face up. At the beginning of your ride phase, if you have a Vanguard with Celestial, you may pay the cost if you do the top card of your deck into the damage zone face up. Choose a Vanguard until end of turn it gets continuous Vanguard. While you're paying the cost for Stride, all cards in your hand get grade +2. There is a new pretty decent Stride for Celestials coming out. And the Celestial they do have, Mikhail. Is actually pretty good, and like summon something, give it +5k. So she is worth playing, and even then, even if you're not striding a Celestial card, you know, she doesn't require that. I'm just saying that some of the Celestial stuff is good. You can use it to get a Gavriel if you want, though honestly I don't think Gavriel works as well with Celestials as she does with Rescue. But yeah, good card, actually. You know, if you have another grade 1 in hand, you can just pay it and stride. Raphael on Field of Damage. Black Mirage Hagiti. I think. Rescue 2. Act Rearguard. Once per turn. Chi Break 1. Counterblast 1. Tap this unit. That's a lot of stuff. If you have 5 cards in your damage zone, choose 2 cards from your damage zone. Heal them. Choose one of your vanguards. Deal 2 damage. Basically, counterblast, tap it, and you switch out 2 and put in 2 new ones. Which can be good, which can be bad. It can certainly activate her skills. And it can even replace herself with her skills, depending on what you get. She is a card that is a 1 or 2 of. And, like, she's just an engine to get rescue going. I'll put it like that. Excellent Celestial, Yofiel. When this unit is placed on rearguard from your damage zone, if you have a Vanguard with Celestial, this unit gets +3k. Damage zone, counterblast 1. If you have a Vanguard with Celestial and a card in your damage zone with the same card name as a card in your Vanguard circle, call this card to open rearguard circle. From face up. If you call, put the top card of your deck into the damage zone face up. Name of Heart is included. So basically, by the way, if you just counterblast and you use the same thing, it doesn't count. But basically, let's say you stride and you have 3 counterblasts open. Basically, this has to be face up because otherwise it's not a card. It's the same thing as lock, if I'm understanding the ruling correctly. Counterblast the one that isn't a copy of the Vanguard, and you can place it right here. Basically, an open rearguard circle. The benefit of this is that it does give you more attacks. It doesn't gain power, but it's an 11k anyway. And if you're playing something like Zerachiel, it'll become 14k, and the thing behind it is probably like a 12k booster or some bullshit, which can make this whole thing a 26k column. It's actually going to replace Helm, which is the current card that I'm comboing up with Zerachiel. Alright, that's Angel Feather. I'm now going to move on to Shadow Paladin, which I'm sure you've all been waiting for, honestly. Because, let's face it, Shadow Paladin is the main stuff of this set, and will continue to remain so. Alright. So, commons. Commanding Knight, Nissa. I actually like her a lot. She's a new starter. It's a new starter. Her ability is pretty simple. Act Rearguard, GB1, Ritual 3. Tap this unit, choose 2 of your only units, and they get +4k until end of turn. So basically tap 2, give the front row +4k. I like her because I'm building a Dark Distress Dragon deck. So basically you can tap her, give the 2 units that are going to survive a Dark Distress, because you kill as much as all 5 of them, but really you just kill 3 to get his real effect off. Because any more, that's just overkill. And so you get +8 to a column, and then you use other skills. You kill her and others for their effects, and you gain card advantage. It's pretty great. Lingering Knight Revenger Conrad. He's a clone. Act Rearguard. Put this unit into the soul. Choose a normal unit from your hand. Discard it. Top card. Put it at the top or bottom. Draw a card. If you have a face-up card in the G-Zone, choose one of your units +4k. 5k, excuse me. You never really use that second skill because you don't wait that long. But honestly, if you want to get Ritual done really fast, he's pretty great. And the fact that you can basically check the top card, and if you need it, you can draw it. He's just, like, these clones are pretty solid. And in Ritual, he is a useful card. Like I said, though, I like her a bit better, but that's because she's cute. Also, she works better with what I have in mind for my Lord build. However, if you're not being crazy, play him. Kind of last one. I mean, crit trigger. Knight of Iron Cluster Craftine. Auto. GB1 Ritual 3. When this unit is placed on rearguard from hand, until end of turn, this unit gets auto. When this unit is retired from rearguard for the effect or cost of your card, look at 2 cards from the top of your deck. Search for 1 card among them. Put them into your hand, the rest in the drop zone. So basically, this guy works with Dark Distress. But when it says the effect, that means that Shadow Paladins are no longer limited by the cost of a card's ability. So you look at top 2, search for 1 card, put it into your hand, and the rest into the drop zone. Top 2, choose 1, put into hand, drop zone. In other words, put something into your hand. This is Ritual 3 Mind, but you can basically continue on the ritual for Luard, which is, I'm sure, its original intention, but I'm not that guy. Revenger, Weight Gore Dragon. When your other unit is retired from Rhaegar for the effect of the cost of the card, if you have a Vanguard with Raging Form in the card name, this unit gets +3k. It's an okay skill. Basically, if you're planning on having one card remaining or one column remaining, that's how you why you play him. Detecting Revenger Aif, Act Rhaegar, tap this unit, reveal top 5, choose a Raging Form, put it into your hand, shuffle deck. If you do not put it into your hand, choose another unit and it gets +2k. She's alright. Basically, if you know that you have a thin deck and you know there's a Raging Form in there, or you're going to retire her for various abilities, you can do it. Not much else to say about her, though. Lead Bow. Bow, bow, wow, UPO, UPA. Auto, choose a card from your hand, discard it. When this unit is retired from Rhaegar for the cost of an effect of the card, you may pay the cost if you do draw a card. Drop and draw. Honestly, I don't really care to use him with Dark Distress, but I might. He's just one of those cards that's like, if you just need draw on your build, he's good for it. Ferocious Attack, Revenger, Dylan. Auto, Rearguard, GB1, Counterblast 1. When this unit attacks a Vanguard, if you have a Vanguard with Raging, pay the cost. If you do, choose one of your Vanguards, +5k. That unit and this unit get +5k. I don't much care for that. Even though you can do it multiple times, it's basically a 14k or 21k if you have a 7k booster. Attack that doesn't, you know, it's just a little bit more pressure, but it's a counterblast, and I really don't know. Well, I'm gonna put it like this: I don't play Raging Form, so I don't know if this is a good cost or how many counterblasts they use, because Raging Form himself does not use any counterblasts, but I believe his grade 4 does, as well as certain other cards that support him, like Maur. Assist Alner Mygase? I can't pronounce the GHN sound. You can blame the Celts. Damn, Celts. Continuous Vanguard, Rearguard, Ritual 3. This unit gets +2k. Interestingly enough, this works on your opponent's turn. And if you have Ritual for some reason, she has a 10k defense. That makes her pretty good in a defensive build for Ritual, which is a thing. When this unit intercepts during the Battle of the Vanguard, it's attacked, +5k guard, which is okay. Honestly, she's a lot more useful than others just because of the defensive nature potential, defensive potential of this card, especially with Ritual being such a flexible build. However, she still has problems, like the fact that she's AK and the fact that she still requires 3 Rituals early game to be good as a 10k defense. Nine of Serial Blade, Diarmid. Auto, Vanguard, Rearguard, GB1, Ritual 3. Choose one of your other Rearguards and retire it. When this unit attacks a Vanguard, pay the cost if you do +3k. Until in a battle, and at the end of battle, your opponent chooses one of his or her Rearguards and retires it. So basically, alright, let's talk about why we would use this card. The only reason you use this card is with when you have PBD to DDD, and specifically in Diablo. You can run PBD to DDD with Luard, however, he is not as efficient as he is in Diablo. This is a perfect companion for Blasted Art Diablo. You might be like, what about Vortimer? I'm like, that's a different build of Diablo. This is a retire-based build, and honestly, I don't think Vortimer's worth a damn. He can get a lot of grade 1 cards out, but honestly, he was never the threat. The strides that were over him were the threat. And when you have that situation, he's just a glorified replacement for Clarensword, which is what he was designed to be. Like, Clarensword was very imperfect. However, Vortimer fixed him. Luard fixes Claret Sword further, but loses the offense, and instead focuses on a flexible build of either offense or defense. But basically, you attack with this guy, you choose Full Ball Diablo. Full Ball Diablo summons out Blaster Dark Spirit. Blaster Dark Spirit, you finish the ability with the +3k. This is later. So Blaster Dark Spirit kills something in the front row. Then the opponent can choose something to die. He's an improvement over Deathspray Dragon because he gets +3k and because, which can be pretty powerful and hit above 21. And because the opponent has to wait till end of turn, no counterblasts. His weakness is that he's a 10k defense. Alright, let's talk about Abyssal Isle. Abyssal Isle is one of the best rares in this set, bar none. It's probably, honestly, he's probably the best rare in this set. he's certainly going to have the abyss, biggest effect. When this unit is placed on rearguard from hand, shoot, look at top 7, search for one Luard and a card name among them, reveal it, put it into your hand, shuffle deck. If you put a card into your hand, choose one or more cards, some of their grades being grade 3 or greater, and discard them. Basically, he gets you instant ritual when you use it, because you discard 3 grade 1s. However, that is such a minus. Such a minus, you don't want to do that. So basically, you discard a grade 3 for a grade 3. So in other words, if you've got this guy running around, Ildona, you can switch him out for a Luard. Aldo, Ritual 3, when the scene is retired from rearguard to the effect or cost of one of your cards with Luard and the card name. Basically, if you stride over a Dark Distress Dragon and use the ability, you can countercharge one of this. This unit includes itself in its own ritual ability. Other cards don't have that skill. Case in point, Lead Bow. When this unit is retired. Actually, no, that's not ritual. Shit. Ooh, this is the only grade 1 with ritual around here. Especially when it has a cost and effect ability. Yeah, Leofail does not. What's the other one? The other grade 1 that has the ability on boost, kill something in the same column with this unit. Yeah, it doesn't count. Yeah, it counts itself for ritual, which is a really good ability now. It is much better than it was before. I read it, but it's one of those things where it's like, eh. I like him. I'm going to be playing him, and he will be great in Dark Distress because he countercharges. So he can do it multiple times. Also, Luard has a way of getting soul, which is pretty great. I'm sure it'll be pretty nice. Revenger, Detonate Heat Dragon. When this unit attacks a Vanguard, if you have a Vanguard with Raging in its card name, this unit gets +2 Cantil in a battle, then this unit gets... So it just gets +2 when it attacks. Then it gets auto rearguard, counterblast 1, retire this unit at the end of your turn. You may pay the cost. If you do, you can search for one Abyss Dragon with Limit Break 4 from your deck, reveal it to your hand. Put it into your hand and shuffle your deck. Reveal it, put it into your hand, shuffle your deck until end of turn. So basically, if you want to, you can then replace it for a Raging form, or even... Actually, that's not Raging. I don't think there's any other grade 3s with Raging that I can think of off the top of my head. And besides that, you wouldn't want them, you want Raging form. It's just one Abyss Dragon. Ha! In other words, he pays for the Stride's ability. And just the fact that it's an 11k attacker is pretty good. However, I don't really think you'll use this ability too much unless you're desperate for the Abyss Dragons. Again, I'm not really seeing too many counterblasts for this stuff. But so I think it's really just a good card to run in any Revenger build, especially Raging Form. It has to be in a Raging Form build. I accidentally bent this card. There we go, good as new. Can't tell. Then we have Revenger Slay Hex Dragon. Counterblast 1, choose a card from hand, discard it. When this unit is placed on Vanguard and rides a Revenger, you may pay the cost. If you do, search your deck for a Revenger Raging Form Dragon, ride it, stood, shuffle deck. If you rode, put this card into your hand from the soul. So basically, how to parse this unit out? It's like Bela for Chrono Jet Dragon, except a bit different. So counterblast 1, it rides a Revenger. This rides a Revenger, counterblast 1, discard a card from your hand, any card. Then you replace it with a Raging Form and put this back into hand. It is an Abyss Dragon, so in other words, it can pay for the stride cost. It can pay for the stride cost, holy cow. So basically, you put it in the hand, then you can stride. This will be the companion for Raging Form for the time being. PBA is good, however, it was always a PBA or Raging Form, but now it can be Slay Hex Dragon and Raging Form all the time. Huzzah! However, you will need to counterblast. Mage of Enticent, Ildona. Auto, Vanguard, G-Break 1, Ritual 3. Choose two of your rear guards and retire them. When this unit attacks the vanguard, pay the cost. If you do, draw two cards. This unit gets plus 3k until end of battle. Auto. And that's an okay ability. Like, Ildona, that's basically what Ildona does. Except he doesn't have Counterblast 2 with him, so that's good. Counterblast 1, Soul Blast 1. This unit plays some Vanguard, pay the cost. If you do, top 5, search for a ritual, reveal it, put it into your hand, shuffle your deck. So, he's basically one of the better companions for the Ward. Not just because he works with ritual, but because he also can act on his own thing when you cannot stride. Weirdly, the anime is portraying ritual cards. It's having problems striding. Especially since they have no stride fodder for Luard at this time. However, I think that that's not really a problem in the long run for this clan. And that we will be soon enjoying some very strong attacks and whatnot. Especially since you build primarily a defensive-offensive build with things like the Stand Trigger. And others, because the Stand Trigger, when it is retired for the cost of effect, it doesn't really replace itself, but it does give you cards for killing it, as well as fuels more ritual. It's just, you know, it's one of those things where you kind of want something that works in the Vanguard, rearguard circle. However, as a Vanguard, he is not bad. I kind of wish he was Limit Break for us before. Ildona was a card that saw a lot of use. It's probably one of the few cards that were really long-lived, as it stayed on past Claret Sword in some places, especially since it could hit 16k by itself. However, once Stride Meta hit, it did disappear for a lot of it and was replaced by Diablo. It did not see complementary use with Diablo in my meta. And I honestly don't think those two work together at all, especially since Deathspray Dragon, Claret Sword, and a few other grade 3s were better used in that position. It's a pity. I'm hoping Ildona will see much more use in the future. Personally, I'm not going to be using him, but then again, I haven't really chosen what my grade 3 is yet, so I might be using him. the thing is, this guy doesn't work with Luard too much, and honestly, I don't want to really run 10k with him. If I were to run anything, I'm still working on that question, actually. I thought about using Desperate Dragon, which is a bad card. It was a set 15 triple rare that is bad. It is bad. It is bad. It is bad. But, like, I thought it was during the ride phase. If you, at the end of, beginning of the ride phase, if you, kill something and then they kill something. However, that's not how it works. It's beginning of main phase, which means you can't stride. So it's a terrible card. It just continues to be a terrible card. It continues to astound me that it is a terrible card. It is one of those few cards that should never have been printed, or if it was, it should have been a rare. That's how bad they jumped it up. Honestly, Luard doesn't have very many good companion cards for grade 3s, but Ildona is certainly a good step in changing that. However, most of his... he's a clone of the support cards for Luard, or Ritual rather, of the support cards for the... oh my gosh. Keyword? However, you know, he doesn't work with the actual ace of the keyword, Luard. However, that's not too big of a problem. It's just a minor problem. Oop. Actually, no, it's fine. I can just go into this. This is the Cray Elemental card that came with it. Light Elemental Honnelly. Continuous rearguard. All rearguards cannot attack the vanguard in the fifth attack or more unless that counterblast one is paid. When this unit is placed on rearguard, choose a face-up card in your damage zone, turn it face down. This card is from all clans and all nations. So, this card is a bit of a bitch. And I mean it in a good way, sort of thing. It's one of those cards that if you face a lot of Aqua Force or Nova Grapplers, you know, it can be pretty good. And especially with things like Nova Grapplers, let's say that they're using Bastard. So they're playing Bastard, they restand 3 units. However, when you're using Bastard, generally you're on the 3rd or 4th attack. So basically, you use Counterblast 2 to stand up a bunch of units, as well as stand up Bastard himself. Bustard. There we go. Now, Bustard, he's usually at the 4th or 5th attack. he swings for the fifth attack. Because he's always going to be the fifth attack. If he's a sixth attack, which can happen with certain of the Victor support, that means that, for a second attack, I mean, that means that you have to counterblast one. And or let's say that he is the fourth attack himself, so with his other attack, you survive it. So they swing with the rearguard. They just used up at least 3 to 4 counterblasts. They might not have enough when they attack to use his skill and preserve him. However, the fact that you must turn a face-up card and your damage on it, turn it face down, is a bit of a pisser. And it can negatively affect your card game. Alright, I'm going to do one little thing real quick. This card is fairly unplayable, but it has its uses. I'm going to go over each clan again, and just basically going over which card is playable. Abyss Owl is playable in all situations that involve Luard. All Raging Form, guaranteed Raging Form, and this is kind of maybe. Whatever, maybe. He's basically a maybe. Maybe card certainly works in Luard. Again, works in Luard, but a maybe card. In fact, this probably won't see very much play. So, no. There's better cards. Yes. This will see some play, but not much. I don't think it'll see much play in the tops. Yes. But as a 2 of. No. Dylan, maybe. I don't know enough about Raging Form to see whether this is good or not. Assist Nalar Magnals? No. Sorry. Yes, but only in Diablo, based on retiring the opponent so that they cannot guard PBDDDDD. Let's take a look at Angel Feather. At least two of. Hagiti and Bakaria are both at least 2 ofs. This is a yes, 4 of, with Zerachiel. Grade 1, zero, commons. No. Yes, but only in non-OCL builds. And high builds that require, like, soul, she will also be used in. No, there's better cards to use. And besides that, draws are a bad choice in Angel Feathers. Maybe, if you like the art. No, the art's better. No, these two are both maybes, depending on whether you run them or not and like the new art. I like the new art for this one, but this one's bad. First Aid, Corgi? Maybe. Probably not, but maybe. 2 to 3 of. 4 of. Araton? Ratiel? No. Just no. He's just not a good grade 3. There's better grade 3s to run. Then we're working on Arakami now. Yes. However, not all builds. Like, he'll be one of those things. Like, him and the other Thunderstrike and the card that's the current starter will be kind of, like, flipped between the two. You know, but other than that, you know, I can't really say how much this will be used, but I will use it. Yes. Training Monk Dragon is a definite yes. Eradicator, Death Scythe is descendant only and a maybe. This guy is a maybe, but maybe in a budget deck. He's definitely a budget card. I'm going to say he's a budget card. But he's not going to see much play because he has no rearguard abilities. Maybe. I don't know. I don't know enough about Dragonic Descendants grade 3 lineup in the new meta, because even though it's an unknown, it just doesn't sit with me right. Ambitious Dragoon, maybe. I don't think so. No, there's better cards. If you like the art, you'll play this. This is a definite yes for all Thunderstrike based cards. Descendant is yes, especially if you run these two cards, which are a big maybe. If you want to run a power build for your rear guards, yes. If you don't want to run a power build from your rear guards, which is most decks, no. However, interestingly enough, she does work with Descendant. So you can boost and then give plus 8k, 15k to your boost, instead of a normal plus 7k. She's a yes. Dragon Dancer Fatine is a yes in all builds involving Thunderstrike. Lightning Phoenix is, like I said, a maybe, probably not. Martial Arts Dragon is a definite yes. He, like Chatura, is guaranteed, it should be in every Voltage build. Zoom Dive Dragon, certainly maybe, but I don't think so. I'm not going to be running him. He is an interesting card, Bisham, and is a maybe. I don't really know how to use him yet. But since he's Vanguard Rearguard Circle and he gets +2 and basically gives you another free column or two more frontline attackers like him, you know, he's a certainly maybe, and I'll be running him myself and seeing how well he does. All right, let's talk about Spike Brothers. He's certainly a 2-3 of Dudley Jetter. She's certainly a 2-4 of Dudley Cheers. He's a 4 of, in my book, Lethal Forward, however, only in a Rising build. And he's a 4 of, maybe, if you want to run him and Jessica together, however, there are alternative uses. Mm-hmm. Let's talk about the commons. Dudley Little Road is certainly a yes. I will be using him. The Perfect Shield is the Heal Trigger, best art, I'm using him. Silence Joker is a yes, but he's a reprint. Mecha Coach is a maybe. No. His art is bad compared to the Panther. 2. Air Force Aliza, certainly 2 of. Maybe even a 4 of if you run that sort of thing, but she's a lot of counterblasts, don't forget. Full Speed Spectre, certainly a 2 of. Dudley Ingram, but remember, Frog Loot Raider is the top card you play in this in the Grade 1 lineup. Everything else is immaterial. Dudley Ingram, certainly in a Dudley build, but no other build. Besides the fact that he's a Dudley, he's just... You know, he might not be as good as he needs to be. Mayhem Tiger is a 4 of in every build. Every build should run Mayhem Tiger. At least 2 of. Certainly 4 in certain situations. Serial Bomber is a maybe. He is Vanguard or Rearguard, but in a Rising deck, I'm pretty sure he'd be pretty good. You know, but he's one of those things that's like an alternative. If you're not running the Heave-Wee's 10K, the Grade 3. Or Outrage Lineback, I don't really feel that he'll see much play. However, he is a Skydiver, and Skydivers are pretty good. So, like, it's one of those things. Like, you'll see in here that the generic stuff is getting a no. Certain things like this are getting a maybe, and this thing is getting a yes. You know, there are different gradations of good card in Vanguard. So be careful. Remember, let's talk about Gear Chronicle. It's all crap. But if you're running Zodiac Time Beast for multiple attacks and power, yes and yes. But honestly, it's bad. I don't like it. I don't think it's good. I cannot give my approval to these two cards. However, if you need more Zodiac Time Beasts, I can't stop you. No. Yes, but you don't want to. Yes, but you don't want to. This is certainly a yes for a lot of builds, but no. It's still not good. Like, none of these cards are good. This is a yes just because it's a Zodiac Time Beast. Like, these are all Zodiac Time Beasts, except for this guy. But they're bad. Like, they're not good. Not good cards. At all. Like, they're not they're barely playable. They are barely playable. This card's playable. This card's barely playable. I don't even want to run them in my build. Let's talk about Aqua Force. This is kind of playable, but honestly, I am not going to play it because there are other cards that are better that unflip damage or can be used when they're called from the deck. Nikitas is certainly playable. Maybe playable. Honestly, if you don't want to run Tetra Drive, he's the best shot. It is a he, right? Yes, he's just super flamboyant. This guy is a definite 4 of. Some people like Skyros better. And honestly, it's one of those things where you choose between Skyros or this. When you play Thavas, you're either playing Kratos or you're playing Skyros. I wish there was like more to say about it, but like, it's either that guy or Skyros. And honestly, I'm going to be playing 2 of each. And I know other people are playing 2 of each. But I think I might go 4 just to see how well he is. This guy, if you really rely on the new Thavasan GR, yes. Kind of. Yes. This is the Sand Trigger. Sure. If you run draws, use her. But if you don't run draws, no. There are better heal triggers. I'm sorry, Sanji, but there are better healers triggers. Defensive builds only, honestly, though, not as much as Orinthia. Or Cynthia, whatever her name is. Maybe. I don't think so. Kind of. Blue Wave Soldier Simon. I talked about him earlier. And I'm going to say yes. He's going to be played. Just because there are cards like the Flamboyant guy who will work with him. I don't think so. Not Paul. Lucianos in Blue Wave only. But only in certain builds and if you can't get other cards. He basically replaced that one guy who gives you the second and third attack. And even then the Wave 2 interferes with certain other Vanguard abilities. So, that's what it is. I think this is a yes. This is a yes. Just because it gives out power. And it helps power up other columns to hit numbers better. However, I don't think there'll be more than a couple of them running around. No. Alright, that's what I think about all the commons and rares. I'll be back with a video with the triple rares, double rares, and any promos.